Coming in iOS 18.3, Visual Intelligence finally gets all the features that Apple showed off at WWDC last year. That means Apple Intelligence should now recognize dog breeds, plant varieties, and even add dates to your calendar just by taking a picture of it. So while I was down here for the Miami World Center opening, I did a little walk to take pictures of landmarks, dates, and yes, I asked multiple people to take pictures of their dogs. I'm making a YouTube video, see if it can recognize dogs, is that all right? So now that it has all the features, here's a review of Visual Intelligence. Also, I actually saw Genmoji advertised on this poster. And is that a popsicle parrot? So first up, recognizing dogs. It felt very strange, but I did go up to multiple people and asked to take pictures of their dogs. I will say most of the time, either the dog wasn't facing me or it was hard to get a good picture of it, so Visual Intelligence just wouldn't recognize it. Sometimes I could send it to ChatGPT and it could tell me a possible dog breed, but I did get it to work once, and I did ask the guy what breed is it, and he didn't know, so Visual Intelligence beat him on that one. Now, if you pull up a picture of like a Dalmatian dog on your computer and use Visual Intelligence on that, it'll recognize it pretty consistently.
And it's not just dogs. You should be able to recognize all kinds of reptiles, felines, fish. It did not recognize an axolotl, for the record, and typically with every animal card, you get a link to the Wikipedia page.
I also tried Visual Intelligence on a bunch of landmarks around Miami. Now, these were landmarks even specified in Apple Maps with special cards and information, and most of the time, Visual Intelligence really struggled to recognize it visually. Now, that sounds strange, but one example is Freedom Tower here in Miami. I got right up on Freedom Tower, looking up at it, and Visual Intelligence just refused to recognize it. Now, if I sent that picture to ChatGPT or even Google Image Search, not a problem. It would tell me what it was immediately. But what I noticed was when I brought my iPhone down more at eye level, all of a sudden I saw Freedom Tower appear on the screen and it recognized it all of a sudden. So this and several other examples really feels like Visual Intelligence is using your location and maps information more so than actual visual recognition. If you use ChatGPT or Google Image, it's all visual and it gets most of these requests most of the time. Another example was the Torch of Friendship here in Miami. As I approached it, it actually would come up on screen sometimes as the landmark. I could tap it and get the information, but if I moved too far away, it just wouldn't recognize it. Even if I zoomed in on it from farther away, it wouldn't pull up the card. Of course, ChatGPT got it right away. But again, it seemed like proximity to a place or landmark is actually what makes it trigger in Visual Intelligence rather than the actual picture of the thing. Also, I did a reverse Google image search one time and it actually gave me Flickr results. I didn't even know that was still around. Overall, ChatGPT was pretty reliable if I really wanted to know what something was. Even a nondescript building, it did have the address on the front of the building, but using ChatGPT search, it told me all about it. Visual Intelligence didn't trigger anything, and reverse Google image search would just be general results. Now, I did go down to the Mildred and Claude Pepper Fountain landmark, and none of the services recognized it. It basically just looked like a construction site, and because the fountain wasn't going, I guess there was nothing recognizable to hold on to. So ChatGPT, Google image search, and Visual Intelligence all failed on that one. I also tried multiple times and from multiple angles to get it to recognize the Kaseya Center. That's where the Miami Heat play, and Visual Intelligence really struggled. It seemed like because there's so many businesses inside, sometimes it would get CVS or some restaurant inside the stadium. But again, it's not using the visual, it seems. So even though I'm looking directly at the stadium, even from multiple angles, Visual Intelligence just refused to recognize it. Also, while I was going around landmarks, is that a floating hut? And is that a ship? Wreck behind it? I don't know what's happening. Now, another new feature in 18.3 is recognizing plants. Before, you could take a picture and use lookup in iOS to see what kind of plants it is, but now you actually get those results directly in Visual Intelligence. Overall, it does okay. I found many times it would give me like 2 to 3 options of what it thought it was, and a lot of times I had to really zoom in to get a single result in Visual Intelligence, but it's nice that those results appear right on the screen rather than having to go to lookup in the Photos app. Now, I will say one weird thing is Visual Intelligence lives in this weird multitasked space where if you have a location or landmark pulled up, you can go back to it if you hold the camera control button on iPhone 16, but you can't swipe to it like in the multitasking view. It feels like I should just be able to swipe back and get to the Visual Intelligence screen, but for some reason you have to hold the camera control. It's the only way to get to that information. Now, when it comes to restaurants and stores, it's really hit or miss. Again, I think because it's not doing a visual search, but rather a location and what's around you, it just gives you a bunch of results. Sometimes multiple will flip through at the top of the screen. And if it's not a well-known restaurant or establishment, sometimes it just doesn't come up. Now, I used Visual Intelligence on Bubblegum Shrimp Co., and that came right up and gave me a ton of information, even multiple ways to order from it or delivery. Starbucks is also very consistent at nailing it. It just shows Starbucks the menu and you're good to go. Strangely, this one didn't send me to the Starbucks app, but rather send me to DoorDash or Yelp or something. So hopefully there'll be some consistency there where if it's a Starbucks, you go to the Starbucks app. But those more well-known establishments are pretty consistent. Now for smaller places like this pizza place, it would just refuse to identify it. That's even though the name of the place is on screen, which again just feels like it's not looking at the thing. Another good example of that is this banyan tree. I did visual intelligence, it would not recognize it. Of course, ChatGPT told me what it was right away, but there's literally a placard with the name of the tree on screen, but visual intelligence just will not pick it up. So a little odd. And finally, when it comes to dates, if you trigger visual intelligence and you have a date on screen, it does a pretty good job of picking it up. I even stood multiple streets away from the Kaseya Center, zoomed way in, you can go up to 6X, at least on the iPhone 16 Pro Max. And even though the date was kind of fuzzy and hard to read, visual intelligence picked it up and prompted me to add it to my calendar. Now, if there's multiple things on screen, sometimes it struggles. So the Apple World Center Miami store sign, it just had the month and day, and it took a long time for me to be able to add it as an event. Sometimes actually taking the picture will help, and then you'll get the option to create event, but then it will struggle on what to title it. So there'll be a lot of manual input, titling it yourself, maybe even putting the location. So it could be improved, but if you're looking just to add a quick date, I think it works. Now, even for the concert picture I took on the stadium, it didn't really pull the artist name or concert name, so it is still a manual process. So overall, now in 18.3, it does all the things Apple said it would. It can recognize dog breeds sometimes, plants most of the time, it'll add dates, and it'll give you some location and business info, usually to sometimes. Overall, I don't think I'm gonna find myself using visual intelligence much. You can just open Apple Maps, and a lot of times it's easier to tap a business location if you want information on that. And if you're wanting to add a date, my Fantastical app is pretty good at adding with natural language. It is cool with the dog breeds, and maybe if you are in a lot of dog parks, you could try it out, although maybe you could recognize most of the dog breeds. And one other note, the more you use visual intelligence, your iPhone does get pretty warm and the battery does take a hit. So it's doing a lot of real-time processing because that camera's open and I think it's just looking for text, pinging your location. And a lot of times you'll see the location arrow up by the dynamic island, and sometimes it'll be highlighted blue, meaning it's detecting something, but a lot of times it's not what I'm looking at. It'll be a nearby business. It really wanted me to look at information about CVS that was near the Kaseya Center, but I'm also really curious how much is pulling visually on screen as opposed to just using your location and trying to approximate what businesses are around you. So if you have 18.3, let me know what your experience has been with visual intelligence, and if you want to know about all the features in iOS 18, I actually did a video of 95 plus features. You'll probably discover some new ones. I'll put that video right up here. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. I also did a tour of the Apple Miami World Center store that's behind me. I got an early look, and there's another special video I can't talk about as I'm recording, but you should definitely check it out, and I'll link that video right over here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.